the man with the best, most appropriate theme music in all of sports.
He sounds sexy.
He's a Super Bowl champion.
A t-shirt
ripper.
A Mr.
Universe. Real talk. And a Fox Sports Radio NFL analyst. And a First Things First regular guest analyst.
Our man,
Greg Jennings.
Greg,
what up?
Jennings.
What's happening?
Hey, so Greg, I hear you're like a great bowler. Please tell me.
Yo, you got to tell us the story, man, or you know I'm going to tell it in a way you ain't going to like.
No, it's, we went out. We had a little outing, Fox family, you know, FS1, Carton Show, you know, New York family. And it was all bad. It was all wrong, man. it was just all wrong. As a bowler, as somebody who professes to be a bowler, to go into a bowling alley without your shoes and ball, it's a no-no. It's a no-no. You know, the oil, the lanes were dry. These aren't excuses. These are facts.
No, those are excuses. We're going to have to have some bowlers call up and see if those are excuses or explanations.
I will say this. My resume speaks for itself. I own every bit of the disappointing, extremely disappointing 114 and whatever else that I bowl.
Because your average is 236, right?
My average is 226.
226.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's a drop-off. That's bringing your F game.
Yeah, absolutely. Something that you thought Dallas was going to do.
Yeah, all right. That's fair.
Shots fired.
I know. All right, let's start there with Dallas. You know, as I thought they would struggle and get beat, quite frankly, by Tampa Bay, I have been saying that their A game is as good as anybody else in the NFC. I just don't think they bring it consistently. Do you think now that Dallas has turned a corner and is going to, you know, play its A game or close to it the rest of the way? And if so, what does that mean?
Well, I certainly hope so, because if they do, then that's great for everyone involved. Every fan that's going to be watching the game that we're going to be able to see this weekend against the Niners, it's going to be impressive. It's going to be one to watch. Look, Dallas can beat anybody if they play up to their standard and expectation of what we feel like they're capable of doing, both offensively and defensively. They just haven't done that. You mentioned it. And so if Dak plays the way that he played, I mean, Dak was special, and it was good to see. It was fun to watch Dak kind of in his mode. Just the game slowed down tremendously for him. It was cool to see.
Well, let me say here, the Cowboys, to me, I can't go forward if I'm the Cowboys with a kicker who misses four extra points. I can't, Greg, because in the playoffs, those kicks, those extra points, those field goals are huge. Ask Adam Vinatieri and Tom Brady. You wouldn't be mentioning Tom Brady without Adam Vinatieri making some of those huge kicks in the postseason to win Super Bowl. So my point is, can you trust him enough? I feel like you can't play him because he has the yips. I would be looking for somebody else.
Well, you say you can't trust him, right, Rob? That's you.
Yes.
But what's your other option? Go out and find somebody who has not performed for you in this situation. Like, you can't do that either. You believe that you have a guy that just had a moment. I remember there was a time. I remember last year. I think Mason Crosby missed like three straight kicks or something crazy, and it was like they didn't panic. This is what he does. We know
four extra points.
They were
Greg.
Field goals.
Okay, they're not field goals. Four extra points.
Okay, understand what?
Okay, it's a difference between missing field goals.
Extra points are field goals now. They're not just chip shots.
Yeah, like, but they're 32 yards, 34 yards?
Greg, what's the percentage of people who make extra points compared to field goals? It's way higher. Don't say that it's the same thing.
It is. And I'm not trying to discredit what an extra point or a field goal is and the difference between them. All I'm saying is he had a moment. Dak Prescott has had them up until this past Monday. Like, and their team was able to find a way to get it done still. So because he's having a moment and he's a kicker and it's like, oh, we can't trust him now all of a sudden. Like, I'm sure everyone on that sideline in that same uniform was frustrated, even more so than what we are. But at the end of the day, it's like, this is who we have right now. So we got to lean into in nurturing what he does, encouraging him, and hopefully he gets back to who we know he's capable of being in the clutch moments, period.
I would be with you if I thought it, like, if it's a receiver that just drops some passes or a quarterback that has a bad day, that to me, that's different because, I mean, obviously that just happens. But I think with a kicker to miss four straight extra points, that's like mental.
So it now is I'm mental.
Worried. I'm,
right.
That's
it's
what
not
I'm
physical.
Worried about. Obviously he can kick, but I'm worried about, is he ever going to get, remember Vanderjack never got over the yips. Like, that's what I'd be concerned about with Greg.
I understand, but where are you going to go and find a kicker that
hey,
you trust?
It's got to be somebody out there.
Greg, I hear you, but they put somebody on their practice squad just in case.
They did.
But
okay,
I'm saying,
I like that.
No, they did because you cannot act like
if he misses the first extra point.
Yeah, what would you do, Greg,
he's
if he
out.
Misses the first extra point? Are you done with him?
If he misses in this game, then you can't. No. I understand what you're saying, and it's like okay. It's either you're in with him or you're out with him. But you can't just say you're out without giving him a chance to redeem himself in another game. If he does it, yeah, we will all say, yeah, they should have got rid of him. Well, if he's lights out this week, then it's like, oh, I'm glad they didn't get rid of him. So we can go either way with it. Fellas, that's all I'm saying.
All right. Let's move on. Do you give the Giants, how much of a, they beat your Vikings, how much of a chance do you give them against Philadelphia?
Man, I give them a strong chance. I really do. I like the Giants, and I'm going to tell you why I like the Giants. I said this after the game in a reaction to the game. Daniel Jones is a top 10 quarterback.
Stop it, Greg. Stop it. Greg, stop it.
I'm glad you said that because I forgot you were kicking that
nonsense.
No,
we were
going
to get to that. Greg, that is a prisoner of the moment. He's had three 300. Well, hold on. And then
he's only had one moment.
He's had three 300-yard games, both two against Minnesota, the worst defense in the league, and the Lions, another terrible defense. He's played better.
Shame on
you. I'll give you that, Greg. But come on, a top 10. Let's start counting. Give me the other. Give me the other nine. Stop it,
Greg. 15 games.
No. You give me the other nine.
No, you have the list. You say he's in your top 10. I just can't believe you could say that Daniel Jones is a top 10 quarterback.
But I can give you nine right now.
Just give me nine.
All right, not in order, but Mahomes.
Whoa. Before you give me these nine, don't be trying to go off last year and resume and all that.
All right, cool. Tell me who you disagree with. Have you looked through it, or did you just
knock
this off the top of the dome?
This is off the top of your head.
Now you
got to
defend
good.
It.
Yes.
All right, look.
No, go ahead.
Mahomes, Allen, Burrow, Hurts, Trevor Lawrence.
Hold on. Who'd you say after
Trevor Lawrence?
No. After you said Burrow?
Hurts.
Okay, Hurts.
Okay, that's five. Tua?
Stop it.
He was in the conversation for MVP before he got hurt.
You're taking Tua right now? I'll give you Tua.
I mean, if you're going to say because he can't play, that's one, but I'm taking Tua. Lamar?
Go, keep going. No.
Not Derek Carr?
No.
What?
You're saying that with a question mark on the end of it. So no.
Jared Goff? No. I mean, I'm saying it because I'm
Jared
like,
Goff had
response.
A better year than Daniel
Cousins?
Jones.
That's 10. And that's just
and you didn't even mention Brady or Aaron Rodgers or Dak.
Stop,
So that's
it.
11 right there.
Stop
easy.
It. You're not taking Kirk Cousins over Daniel Jones.
What? I am. And I know Cousins has his limitations.
You are for this conversation and this conversation only.
No.
Just to prove a point. Yes,
if I had
are.
To start a team, you wouldn't.
Do you hear how quiet Rob Parker is right now?
No.
Greg, come on.
Daniel Jones was great last weekend, Greg. No doubt.
But you really gonna tell me you would take him?
What have you seen from him consistently to tell you you would take him over Kirk Cousins?
He's not turning the ball over. He's going to show up in big moments. He's going to do more with less. He can extend the plays out of the pocket. He can beat you with his arm and his legs. I mean, do I need to continue?
Greg, you just got thrown a 75-yard bomb.
Yeah, I disagree.
You got thrown a 75-yard bomb and you dropped it. Greg, turn off your radio because that is a terrible take by Greg Jennings.
We're going to have to do that as a topic when you're on again.
I don't want to hear neither one of you jumping on the Daniel Jones bandwagon at any moment from this point moving forward. I do not want to hear it.
Greg, you were a receiver. This dude threw 15 touchdowns.
If you were on his team,
you'd be like, yo, give me the ball.
Absolutely. But from what I've seen, when his team needed the most, like, look at.
He had a great game. But can he do it a few more times before we crown him?
That's what we do now. We wait till they do it.
It's
a few
one
more
game.
Times before we clown people.
It wasn't like he was great all year.
He wasn't? Are you telling me he wasn't?
He was solid all year. He wasn't great by any stretch of the imagination.
He was because he was asked to be solid. When he was asked to be great, he was great. When they said, okay, go and run with it, go and run our offense, go throw the ball over 40 times, we're going to rely on you and what you can do, be great and don't let us down, he delivered.
That's because the Vikings can't guard. They can't guard. He threw for 300
yards a game.
Okay.
You lucky the break is coming up, yes. Greg. I mean, my goodness. Unbelievable. All right.
We'll see.
Yeah, we will see. Cause next week you'll be on again, and we'll talk after they play the Eagles. So that's our man, Greg Jennings. Crazy takes notwithstanding, we still love him. Good job, man. Great stuff.